Hello and welcome to the channel. So today we are going to be doing a follow-up on the auto Frunk installation, specifically more it's the LED Frunk light. So this is also coming from the brand Satonic. So this came with the auto Frunk kit that I installed a few weeks ago, which if you have not seen that, I'm gonna put a link to the video up here. Do check that out. I think it's very helpful. Again, I think it's one of the best mods you can make to your car. But part of that kit from Satonic comes with a Frunk LED light, which I think is pretty cool. So this is actually my second kit. The one that came with the car with the initial kit got damaged during installation. I reached out to Satonic via email and they sent me a replacement. It's a light strip that goes under the seal in the Frunk, and when the Frunk is open, it basically lights into the Frunk. This is the cool white one, and so we're gonna go through installing this and then we'll see what it looks like. By the way, you can order this also by itself from the Satonic website, and if you order anything from the website, don't forget you can use the discount code TIT20, that's TIT20, for 20% off of anything. So anything you see up there, if you want to order, discount code TIT20 gets you 20% off. Before we do the installation, I just want to show you here. Like I said, I have two because this one is broken. This is the replacement. I'll put that away for now. I'm going to go through this one here. So basically, it is this flexible strip of rubber. And on one side is like a little clear type gel, not gel, it's a clear side, and then there's a side that's covered. So this is where the light beams from, and so it's pretty long. I don't have the exact dimensions in here, but it's pretty long. So this goes into this will go into the original Tesla light, this will go into your Frunk button, and so basically you're splitting this. But yeah, pretty very simple plug and play, straightforward. And so once you connect that, this goes under the strips of the seal in the Frunk. It goes in a huge circle, and once that's done, you see what that lights up. Some instructions in there, so that's it. No frills to it, but again, I think it's a very useful mod. So having done this, now let's go jump into installation. All right, so for what we need to do, we're installing this. It's gonna go around under the seal. In here, there's this rubber seal that forms a seal around the Frunk. Under there is what we're gonna tuck this into. So here's what I think happened the first time I was installing this and it got damaged. So what I did initially was I had connected everything, the wires, and then I started to tuck it in under. And I think what happened was, as I was tucking it in, I don't know if at some point the wire bent too much and it cut a connection in there, but we're gonna try again and see. And now don't forget, the part with the clear side is what you want down. The part with the white, that goes up. So I'm gonna okay, so right here, this wire will come up this way and it will tuck under here. So if I want to do something like this, to take this off, it's pretty easy. So this is this now. I'm going to take this splice, which is this here, right? Now that goes into the big hole here. So I'm taking that, I'm going to make sure the part that's got the notch is up here. So I push that in, okay, and then this part here goes back to this, and this goes to this. So we're going to do a test first with the light. I'm going to plug this in. This now goes under here. Again, the wire is just gonna stay. You wanna make sure I don't put a wire right in this groove here, so I'm gonna move it a little bit to the side. And then from there, you're just tucking it under the seal. Is just cutting this right at the end here. I'm gonna show you guys just a little tiny line right there to show where I'm gonna cut, and then I'm going to disconnect and then cut all the way. And so putting this back again. So Houston, we have a problem. I've got the auto frunk in my car where I push a button, it comes down. I hooked up the LED frunk and the button in the frunk would not work. And I tried a few things, it would not work. Apparently, I don't know if it's not enough power from the frunk light that's not enough to power both, or if it's interference, but I did some research and I found that it looks like there's not enough coming from the frunk light to power the auto frunk at the same time. So what I found is you have to do some engineering. This double wire here connects to the frunk light. However, this black one is not going to be used. Well, it's going to be used, but not in this way. You have to connect this black one to the body, the chassis of the car. So it's like, I'm going to show you what I have going on so far right here. So this is what I initially, my connection was, this is the black wire going straight and this one here was dangling and it would not work. And what I had to do, in my test, I did some research and I saw something that said I had to connect the black wire to the body. So right, I did a test where I connected this piece directly to the body and boom, that worked. So right now I have this, I'm gonna show you what I need to do here. So I'm gonna go to original setup, how it came from the dealer. This big splitter goes into from the car. This piece here goes into the back of this. And you see, this is on, right? If I press the button now, you should hear the frunk close. You hear that? And you're gonna see it come down. There you go. It's got reverse open. So without the LED strip connected, it works. Now I'm gonna take this, connect it to the LED strip. You see, LED strip lights up. This is still lit up. Now I'm gonna press this button and it's gonna be nothing. Nothing. It works if you use the app or the screen to open or close the frunk. So you don't have to mess with the wiring here if you're not sure. As I mentioned, if you don't feel confident enough to want to mess with the wiring, you don't have to. You can leave it this way, just knowing that this button basically is not going to work. So God forbid, but if you have somebody trapped in here, they literally have to wait then until everything shuts off before they can use this button. also defeats the purpose of having this. Now, if you don't have auto frunk, there will be a problem still, because this will still not work. So if you want to keep this button active and you want to do this, this is what you have to do. So I'm going to disconnect all of this again. What you need to do, I'm going to go back to my other one. So here's what I did. This one here with the round thing, you don't need it. What I did also, this one here, you don't touch. This stays as it is. What I did is on this one that's from, that goes here originally, I took the black wire and I cut it. Cut it right three quarter of the way. I exposed a little bit. In the frunk, basically what you need to do is connect this to the chassis. This is the part from the connector. Now watch this. This piece here, that's the emergency release, the one of the cables on the frunk lock. I'm gonna touch to that. And as you can see, the button, the LED lights up again. This is still lit up. Now I'm gonna press this and then see what happens. There we go. It worked. So you need to connect the black from this to the body. Now, not just any part of the body, you gotta find a good place to touch it to for it to work. So what I'm gonna do here is I'm going to disconnect, so I don't want this to keep sparking on me. Another suggestion would be to just strip this pretty long so you can actually just wrap it around and okay, now moment of truth. Take this big guy, plug it back in. Take this guy here. There we go. So I've got light back, and I'm gonna take this guy and plug it in back in again. I got frunk light, I still got this, and voila. So there you have it. Again, if you want to connect this to this and then just get that to be onto the body, that's fine. I've just bypassed this entirely and connected this straight. I'm going to get a little bit of electric tape and wrap up this piece here. I don't know if it's going to do anything, but just to be on the safe side, I'm going to do that. So all right, so I've got LED strip, I've got this. So again, when you're closing this, when you want to close, make sure the wire is not over that hole. You want to keep that hole clear, because if you clip it, it's going to pinch and you might damage that. So make sure you keep this clear. Of course, now that I've got this here, it's a bit of a pull here now, but just tuck everything on the inside. So first, push down. Again, I'm checking my wiring, make sure it's clear, and it's clear. So click, we're good to go. And well, I hope that was useful and helpful. Hopefully it helps you guys have a much smoother installation of your frunk LED light. And if you found this useful, helpful in any way, don't forget to like, share, and importantly subscribe, so you can be aware of what else we got going on. Also leave your comments. I'd like to hear if you guys had a different workaround or something that you did differently. I'd like to hear a comment, so feel free to put your own feedback in the comments. And as always, thanks for being here. I will see you next time.